and I know just how much I care when I'm carefully folding your clean underwear. I see it's all worth it, though sometimes it sure hurts, putting back in the bureau drawer all my t-shirts. I find the foundations of reason a basis, stuffing the pillows back into their cases. Weak number slings withstand buffets and shocks. It's so clear, separating then mating the socks. Stretching the fitted sheet onto the bed, I recall hairs we've split, blood and tears that we've shed. But love feels secure, dear, somehow I discover, slipping the duvet into its warm cover.
Do you do your own laundry? How much time do you spend doing laundry?
¿Cuánto tiempo tú pasas lavando tu propia ropa?
How do you fold?
¿Cómo la doblas?
Did somebody teach you?
¿Alguien te enseñó?
Who?
¿Quién?
Have you ever had a stain that embarrassed you?
¿Alguna vez tuviste una mancha que te daba vergüenza?
Do you have clothes that you're afraid to wash?
¿Tienes ropa que te da miedo lavar?
Do you do someone else's laundry?
¿Le lavas la ropa a otras personas?
If you don't do your own laundry, who does?
Si no lavas tu propia ropa, ¿quién la lava?
There were these two roly things that would squeeze the water out. I remember those. They fascinated me and scared me. You put the clothes in and squeeze them through. They get pushed through and come out all flat. It was a pre-dryer time. There was a clothesline, of course. We'd hang everything up inside the house when it was raining. Always a big pile of ironing. That was a major part of it. I loved ironing. I'd watch my mom ironing. She'd do it in the evening while watching TV. Everything would get ironed, except socks. I remember folding sheets with somebody else. It was a total thing, the way you'd fold sheets with somebody else.
No me interesa hablar sobre el asunto. Mejor hablemos de otras cosas. Un poco aburrido, un poco difícil de contar. It's just, I don't want to talk about all this dirty. The times you look around and you can't believe how much there is and how you'll never get through it all. And the boss comes in and he watches you. But that time the lady came in and she said I had ruined her favorite pants. She said I'd broken the damn zipper, made a tear or something, and I didn't even remember her stupid pants. So she starts pointing her finger at me, pointing her finger like this, and she goes, you're gonna pay for it. You're gonna pay for a new pair. These cost me $85 or something. I'm gonna talk to your boss, to the owner. Go ahead, I said. And she goes, I'll make sure they take $85 from your pay, you little B-I-T-C-H perra. She uses that word there right to me at the counter, just like that. Nothing, like about nothing, no better than a dog. So I start to get mad, you know? I don't want to go off on her like I can sometime. Like, just explode, you know? Like a bomb or something from pressure, you know? But I catch myself and I think, I'm not gonna do that. I'm not gonna lose it like that. I know that's what she wants. She's getting going, you know, and on purpose. But then I think, where are the pants, huh? Where are they? And I go, show me the pants, the zipper, and that rib. And she opens up her bag, this big old bag she's carrying, and I see it's filled with all kinds of things, old magazines and papers and something like pieces of food all wrapped up, and other stuff, and layers, and then I see there's something wrong here. Her hair, her clothes, her shoes, and I see there aren't any pants, no zipper, no rip. She was just looking for something else.
I try not to look at what other people are putting in, what they're folding. I try not to look at their clothes. But sometimes you can't help it, you know?
The stains I think of the most are usually yellow. The piss, the sweat, the vomit. Like being a detective.
See that guy? He's washing all these pairs of women's underwear. Lots of lace. Black satin, red silk, sheer pink. Pretty sexy. And kind of big. I wonder who he's washing them for. Folding them so carefully. I guess they're his wife's. Or his girlfriends. Or maybe they belong to him.
Sometimes a customer will come in and she'll say a certain thing is special. And I wonder what special really means. They all say special. This blouse or that skirt. It's really special, they'll say. It's kind of a code. It means, be careful, or else.
You see that woman over there with all those sheets and pillowcases? She's got 5 machines going. Full of sheets and pillowcases. Maybe somebody's sick at home and they need to change the bedding every day. Or maybe they have some kind of thing about sleeping in clean sheets every night. Or maybe they run some kind of a hotel or something.
This one time, a woman comes in with just this one blouse and holds it up. Tells me she wore it the other night and now it's full of loud music and could I get it out? And I say, get what out? She shows me this green thread that runs through it and she says, look, it's like a snake wrapping itself around me, the sleeves around the neckline. She goes, pull it out, just pull it out and make it stop. And I go, I'm sorry, miss. I can't help you. You best wash that thing yourself.
When I come to do my laundry, I can't help it. I get to see things I wouldn't normally see, you know? It's a personal thing in a public space. Like getting to open up somebody's closet. Someone you don't know. Seeing what's inside. Their drawers. Their suitcase. I probably shouldn't be saying this. Shouldn't be making you think.
All you get is their name and their bag of dirty stuff. You write it on a tag. A tag for all that sweat, food, oil, tomato sauce, coffee, period stains, and whatever. You know nothing about them. But you also know more than you want to know. You know?
Let's see. I've been doing my own laundry since I turned 15. I'm 50 now, so that's 35 years. And each year, before I had kids, I did it around 3 times a month until I was 32. So that's about 36 loads a year for 17 years. Wait, that can't be all. It must be more than that. It can't be just 36 loads a year. Maybe it's more like 4 times a month or something. Yeah. So, that would have been 48 loads a year, times 12, which is... And then when I had babies, well, I was doing it 2 times a week, so that would be 8 times a month, so that's 96 loads, but wait a minute. Each time I did it, there would be 4 or 5 loads, or 6. So how many, that's 48 loads a month, and 576 loads a year, and my oldest is 21. So now that would be 12,096 loads. Is that possible? But wait. Minus what my son did himself when he turned 14 or 15, and if you factor in the amount of hours spent doing those loads, that would be 1 half hour. Well, no. Well, 1.5 hours if you include the drying cycle, times 12,096, which would be... Thank you. How do I know it's time to do it? When I don't have any clean underwear. Bottom line, you can get away with dirty socks, but never dirty underwear. I'm not very good. I've never been very good. I never really learned how to do it properly. I think about other things when I'm doing it. My mind wanders.
I'm in my own world.
Mi mente se distrae. Estoy en mi propio mundo. ¿Cuánto tiempo tú pasas lavando tu propia ropa?
How much time do you spend doing laundry?
¿Cómo la doblas?
How do you fold?
¿Alguien te enseñó?
Did someone teach you?
¿Quién?
Who?
¿Tú lavas tu ropa de día?
Do you do your wash in the daytime?
De noche.
At night?
¿Tú le lavas la ropa a otras personas?
Do you do someone else's laundry?
De un ser querido.
A loved one?
O de un extraño.
A stranger's.
¿Y si tú no lavas tu propia ropa, quién la lava?
If you don't do your own laundry, who does?
Eso es privado.
It's private.
Solo algo que tienes que hacer.
It's just something you have to do.
Nada más que decir. No haga más preguntas.